This is KITN-TV, Channel 29, Minneapolis-St. Paul.
Golden Gopher Hockey on KITN-TV, Channel 29 in Minneapolis. And the broadcast crew that you're looking at there is from East Lansing, Michigan. You see they're above the goal, which is now going to be defended by State. And they're wearing the helmets. There they are. They're not protected by anything except those helmets. You know, you can laugh only because, Wally, I know you've been in that situation as well as I have. Having done games in the minor leagues and in some smaller buildings where that's the only place to sit, unfortunately, these folks don't have much in the way of protection.
There's none there at all.
As we have the start of the third period in a series that is tied at 5-5. Only one goal scored in that period, that by Jake Cates, his 15th. In 30 seconds, Michigan State will go to a power. Oh, Mazzotti lost it, and it bounced behind the net. From my vantage point here, I thought for a hot minute it jumped in the net. And a finish. With a block, it comes loose to Jernander, centering it. And it was blocked by a sprawling Chris Luongo. Hitman pass to Kip Miller. Step on the defense. Sauber, big save. Watch the rebound. It goes wide. Now Frank Gersich is shaking up.
And just broke loose here. Gersich is the last guy trying to catch him and does a good job in getting some interference. But look at Stauber, 20 feet out of the net, and it's Stauber that really lunched Gersich on the collision, not Kip Miller. Now watch Rod will just come bursting out into your picture here at the bottom, and he'll collide heavily with Gersich. And he knew it right away.
Meanwhile, play back underway.
Miss. Let's watch it once more. Gary Russell, it's a 2-on-2 play. Pitlick will go down here. Shot is made. Yes, it does. It hits the stick of Pitlick and then goes off the crossbar. And he just hit the shaft of his stick about a foot up, and boom, that really fooled Stauber.
Here's a block by Hankinson. He gets it to Bischoff. One man trailing. It's Cates moving right in on goalie centers, and they score!
By the Gophers, but Michigan State very uncharacteristic of getting caught out of position.
Pitlick didn't get all of that shot. All right, we're ready to go some more.
Still 6:59.
The old barn is rocking. Hamilton playing it away. Luongo has it. Here's a steal by Richards. A shot to go. Minnesota won 4-2. I don't know what Coach Wood said in that intermission, Frank, but his team has come out pumped.
Be awarded until Monday evening. They're just trying to jack the bid up, I guess, a little bit. Here's Stauber making a save in close on Kevin Miller. 14 of period two. And the Gophers have scored the only two goals of the third period by Grant Bischoff and Todd Richards, 10 minutes apart. The Gophers lead in the series now 7-5 with a minute and 11 to go. And Muzzotti has been pulled.
Kip and Kevin Miller up front along with their leading scorer, Bot.
Tilly fires. Saved by Stauber. The rebound cleared by Skarda. 14 seconds left. A scramble for the loose puck. Skarda picks it up. He's got an open net. 3-on-1 as they hit the line. Skarda waits, centers to Miller. Shot to goal. They're on their way. They go the Lake Placid.
8-5.
2 seconds, 1 second. It's all over. 3 straight years to the Final Four for Doug Moog and the Golden Gophers of Minnesota.
Series of hockey. Just great. You couldn't ask for anything better.
If you didn't enjoy this one, you'll never enjoy the game of hockey in your life. Final salute to the fans, and Mariucci Arena will erupt again as it is starting to erupt right now. The circle forms at center ice, and there's the salute. And it's on to Lake Placid, and we'll recap this great weekend of hockey.